ask most people what they know about honeybees, of course they're going to tell you that honeybees make honey. It's in the name, honeybees. They know that honeybees sting because they've probably been stung by a honeybee themselves in the past. And they also know that honeybees communicate through dances. Now, how do we know that? Well, a remarkable scientist, Karl von Frisch, who is Austrian, did a series of studies to try to figure out how worker honeybees are able to communicate to their sisters the quality and the direction and the availability of food. Karl von Frisch then famously deciphered the honeybee dance language and was awarded a Nobel Prize for it in the 1970s. From there, the dance language has been popularized. Many people know about it. Bee scientists learn about it in elementary type of learning in college. We also know that even in animal behavior type classes, people talk about how remarkable the honeybee dance language is. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the honeybee dance language, the different variations of that language, and how information is coded into that dance that's communicated from the dancing bee to the sisters who are watching that language, and then hopefully to demystify some of this entire process for you so that you can truly appreciate how remarkable honeybees are. There are really three types of dances that honeybees use to communicate to their sisters about food resources. Now, a lot of people will say it's not really three types at all, it's really just one type that kind of opens up or closes, but I'll just say for purposes of this discussion that there are three types, and I'll kind of talk you through those three types and what they mean and how bees use it. The first of those is the round dance, and as the name implies, it's this circular pattern that they dance. The last of those three is the figure eight or the waggle dance, and the reason I went from the first to the last, skipping the second, is because that second dance is really a transition dance. It's a movement away from the circle dance to this waggle dance or figure eight. Now, some recent research suggests that all three of those dances actually occur in the figure eight pattern that we know specifically with the waggle dance. Regardless, I believe it's useful to talk about them as three independent dances so that you can see the transition from language that bees are using to communicate close resources, those resources that are close to the hive, all the way to resources that are some distance from the hive. When talking about the dance language of honeybees, it's important to recognize that there are a couple of bees involved in this. And the first of those bees would be the scout bees. They comprise about 10% of the forager forces. These are the bees that travel outside the hive without the guidance of the dance. Think about them as the ones who leave first thing in the morning looking for those resources to try to steer the colony's efforts towards collecting. So these scout bees will go out, they'll find resources, and they'll come back to the nest to report those resources to other bees, which they do through dances. Well, most dances occur on combs within 24 centimeters of the hive's entrance. So that's just relatively close to the nest entrance. Now, the recruit bees, the second type of bee, they're the ones who are, for lack of a better term, unemployed. They are waiting for instructions from a dancing forager. So they're waiting to make their decision on when to start and where to go based on these returning scout bees or foragers coming in with resources already ready to communicate where they go. And so these unemployed recruits will usually observe a single dance at random before leaving in search for the forage that was being communicated through that dance. Employed recruits will also come back to dance to convey updates about a known resource pool. So the scouts go out first, they gather information, they come back and dance, recruits start going out, and now everybody becomes essentially a bee that will go out, collect food, and come back in and dance to communicate the resources out there in the environment. Now, the dancers can employ path integration to calculate and communicate a direct path to a resource, even if they took a convoluted path to get there, which is really remarkable to think about. So once the recruits then are drafted through these dances, they'll gather resources from the site until that site becomes depleted or until extenuating circumstances prevent forage. And that might be bad weather, cold, rainy, things like that. So let's start with the first of those dances, and that's the round dance. The round dance is used to communicate resources that are within about 15 meters or about 50 feet of the nest. So the forager initiates this dance by exchanging resources with unemployed recruits. So she'd be saying, hey, here, taste what I just gathered from the environment. These resources provide odor cues as well as taste cues. They'll know the quality of that food as well. The dancer then makes small circles, reversing their rotation every 1 to 2 circles while emitting noises and exchanging food with the bees that are watching the dance. So the vigor, the intensity, the length of that dance, a few seconds to several minutes, can indicate the quality of that resource. So after observing the dance, the recruits leave and fly around the hive, usually finding the resource within 5 minutes. But the key with the round dance is the dancing bee is communicating, food is close. Here's what it smells like. Go get it. Here's the quality. Go get it. Now I'm going to skip the transition dance to the waggle dance and then talk about the transition dance last to kind of help you connect the dots between the circle dance, the round dance that I just talked about, and the waggle dance or the figure eight dance that I'm talking about now. The waggle dance is used to communicate resources that are over 100 meters from the hive. And unlike the round dance, the waggle dance does convey direction and distance. Think about the waggle dance as a figure eight, where you've got the circuits, the loops that make those big circles of the eight, and then you've got the straight run in the middle that connects those two circuits. So if you scale it down to a B, the straight run is where the dancer is moving at a very specific angle while shaking or waggling, therefore the waggle dance, her abdomen. And she'll do this multiple times per second. So she's vibrating her abdomen multiple times per second. During that dance, she's creating buzzing noises with her wings and her flight muscles, and she'll stop to exchange food with unemployed recruits that are watching the dance. So again, you've got this straight run and you've got the circuits. Well, the distance to the resource is conveyed in several ways within that waggle dance, including the total length of that straight run, as well as how long that bee is in the straight run. And of course, the duration of waggles or buzzes and the number of circuits where you get what we call the dance tempo. So generally speaking, every 1 second that a worker bee dances in the straight run equals about 750 meters distance from the hive. So if she dances 2 seconds, the worker in that straight run, the worker bee is communicating that the food resources are about 1,500 meters or about 1.5 kilometers from the nest. If she dances just 1 second in that straight run, it's about 750 meters. Keep in mind, this can vary by the stock of bee, the race of bee, the strain of bee. It can vary based on where the bees are, so I'm giving some overgeneralities here, but in general, about 1 second of dance in the straight run equals about 750 meters. These directions usually get the foragers about 90% of the way to the resource, with odor cues helping them get the rest of the way and zero in on the food resource that they're actually going to collect. So that's distance in the honeybee dance. It's communicated based on how long that bee is dancing in the straight run. Direction is a little trickier to explain and it often throws people off, but it's communicated based on the angle of the straight run relative to the sun's azimuth. Okay, so if you were to draw a line from the sun straight down to the horizon, that would be the azimuth. So think about it this way. You've got this figure eight dance that's composed of 2 circuits, the 2 loops, and 1 straight run. Imagine the bee dances straight up in the straight run on the comb, circles to the right, then dances straight up again, circles to the left, dances straight up again, circles to the right, and so forth. The key is that straight run. It's straight up on the comb. Well, the sun is represented on the face of the comb at the top of the comb. So if the bee is dancing straight up in the straight run, she is telling her recruits that the food resource is in the direction of the sun's azimuth, or in the direction of the sun to make it easier to think about. If in the straight run the bee is dancing straight down, she is communicating to her recruits, her sisters, that the food resource is exactly opposite direction from the sun. If the bee is dancing straight right in the straight run, so she dances straight right, makes a loop, dances straight right, makes a loop, dances straight right, that's a 90 degree angle to the right of up. The sun is up on the comb, so a bee that is dancing straight right is communicating to her recruit sisters that the food resource is a 90 degree angle to the right of the sun once you leave the nest. You can almost imagine the waggle dance as imprinted on the face of a clock, where the direction of the sun's azimuth, the line from the sun to the horizon, always being the number 12. So the sun is the number 12 on your clock. And the colony is in the very center of the clock, and the direction of the straight run is the minute hand. If it's pointing at the 9, that's 90 degrees to the left of 12, so the bees will go out, find the sun, and fly 90 degrees to the left. A little tricky, yes, but if you think about it again on the face of that clock, it really helps make it easier to understand. Now, you not only have distance communicated in that straight run and direction communicated based on the angle of the straight run, but you also get quality of the resource coded into the dance. And it's interpreted through the intensity of the dancers wagging and buzzing, as well as the number of those circuits or loops that she's performing. A higher quality equals a higher intensity of the dance. More vibration, more quick circuits, etc. Quality can also be conveyed by the dancer's odor and the food they share with observing recruits. And during the dance, the recruits will emit a squeak or a begging signal that causes the dancer to pause and offer them food. Now, remember that all of this was discovered and interpreted by Karl von Frisch. And of course, there have been controversies since. Some folks have said, well, bees are dancing in a dark colony. The workers can't see the dance. Well, despite that, we can watch the dances and know exactly where the bees are foraging. So everything that I've told you up until this point is generally held for the dance language of the bees, but it's not without controversy as people try to continue to make sense of some of the idiosyncrasies encoded into the dance. Now, I've talked about the round dance. I've talked about this complex and beautiful waggle dance. Now I'm going to speak very briefly about the transition dance. And the transition dance, if you think about it, is going from the round dance, the circular pattern, and opening it up to be the waggle dance. So if circular dances, if round dances communicate resources that are up to 15 meters from the hive, if the waggle dance communicates resources that are over 100 meters from the hive, then this transition dance communicates resources that are within 15 to about 100 meters from the hive. The dancer in this case will perform a dance that falls somewhere between that circular round dance and that more figure eight waggle dance. And these are highly variable. They can take any form in the range from wound to waggle. And all of the information in this dance that's being conveyed falls somewhere in the interpretation strategies of the round to the waggle dance. I think it's most important to know that there's this transition from this more circularly structured round dance to this figure eight dance. But the key is that the bees use all these variations of dances very effectively to communicate the direction of the resources, the quality of the resources, etc., so that when the recruits are watching, they know where to go to gather these resources to bring them back to the nest. I think you could agree with me that this dance language is really remarkable. The fact that honeybees can code into it distance, quality, all of these things that they're putting into a dance that other worker bees are having to watch in a dark hive, it's just remarkable.